Hey, what's going on, everybody? Jake here with Venter Visuals, and today I am stoked because we are going to be breaking down what keyframes are, how you can use them, and I'm going to show you guys in real time how you can apply keyframes to your own clips to get different effects. I wanted to do this video because I've noticed that a lot of beginner video editors don't utilize keyframes enough in their video edits, and I think keyframes are very, very important for stylizing your own clips and taking your edits to the next level. In today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys how to use keyframes to add motion to your clips, create your own effects and transitions, and overall just make your entire video look much better. If you're excited about discovering the true power of keyframes in Premiere Pro, hit the like button down below and let's get into the video. So let's go ahead and take a look at this music video and just catch a vibe for how this video already looks.
I'm a hero, oh. You can't tell me no, I can never go, I got my eyes on the road. Bitch, I'm a hero, oh, you can't tell me no, I can never go, I got my eyes on the road. Yeah, bitch, I'm a hero, we count zeros, I can't chill. Put my city on the map, so bro, I know this shit for real. I came from sticks and bricks, just tell me how I'm supposed to feel. I don't know where we gon' go, but I just know we gone from here. I'm a boss to pay the cost, so tell me how I'm supposed to live. Even though my pocket's full, I'm in this shit alone for real. I can't take no breaks or early mornings, you know I'm supposed to steal. Put my mama on the beach and buy my people close to crib, yeah.
So let's take a look at this clip right here, right? He's standing in front of the car and there's no zoom happening. It's just a very flat shot. So what we're going to do is add a little bit of our own movement into this shot. So the simplest way to add motion to any clip is to come up here under your effect controls, come down under motion. You're going to toggle the animation stopwatch right there, and that's going to create what we call a keyframe. That's what this is right here. So at this particular point in time, the scale is going to equal 100%. Now, if we wanted to say zoom this clip in, what we could do is move this keyframe to the very front and then increase the scale value here as the clip continues, and then we can drag that keyframe to the end. Over time, this clip actually now has a little bit more of a subtle zoom, which just helps to add more movement to your edits. If we right click on this first keyframe and come down here to ease out, for example, with this ease out keyframe, you'll notice that the zoom gradually zooms in instead of it just going directly into the zoom. It kind of gradually slows into the zoom. Another way you could get even more customizable with your keyframes is anytime you create a keyframe, you can come over here to this drop down arrow. You should see these speed graphs that appear right here. And with these handlebars, as I drag this point around, this handlebar, it's changing things on the screen and it's basically manipulating this keyframes. In this example, you can see that it's going to start zooming very, very slowly and then it's going to pick up speed towards the end. So you can see it right there. It just kind of slowly punches in there until the end where it kind of like zooms in a lot faster right there, boom. Now I'm actually going to delete these keyframes here, take the zoom off of this clip, because I find a better way to add motion is by using an effect called transform. And this is because transform actually has motion blur in the effect itself. So let's click and drag a transform effect onto this clip, and then we can make keyframes under scale and position. Let's drag those to the very left, and then let's increase the scale. Let's go to like 180, and then we can increase the position here. Let's change the position values so that we're all centered up. And then we're going to take those values and move them to the very far right. So as I scroll over, you can see we're zooming in here. The cool thing about transform is when you come down under shutter angle right here, you can increase the motion blur. So once I turn my shutter angle up here to 360, you can see that the sides of this clip get a little bit blurrier. And this is more authentic because it looks like an actual zoom that's within the camera itself. Now, if I were to turn this transform effect off, you can see there it is before and here it is after. You can see that these edges are a lot blurrier. So another example of how I like using keyframes with my music videos and other hype creative edits is by adding flash effects into my clips. So if I just come over here to my effects and I type in an effect called Luma Corrector, I can click and drag that onto whatever clip I want to apply this flash effect to. So with my Luma Corrector on this clip, we're actually going to keyframe some of these values under our our effect controls. So what I'm going to do is create a keyframe for the brightness, the contrast level, the gamma, the pedestal, and the gain. And then what I'm going to do is drag all of those keyframes a little bit farther down in my timeline here. I'm going to come to the first where I can see kind of the first part of this clip, and I'm going to change these values. So let's increase the gain to 1.2. Let's go with the pedestal. Let's take that up to like a 0.4. Let's increase the gamma a little bit. We can take the brightness up even more. And now what I can do is highlight these secondary keyframes, because we're going to go right back down into what it looks like regularly, and there will be no flash after these keyframes. So what I can do with these keyframes selected is right click on them and hit ease in. And that's just going to ease in our flash and make it look a little bit more crispy. And then what I'm going to do is take these first couple of keyframes, drag them all the way to the left so it's hitting right on that very first frame there. And then what I can do is just manually adjust the length of this flash effect so it can just last for a couple frames right there. Even though my pocket's full, I'm in this shit alone for real. I can't suppose to know. Even though my pocket's full, I'm in this shit alone. And then what you can do, if you want to, you can click on this effect Luma Corrector. You can right click on it and save it as a transition preset or whatever you want to call it. We can just call it Luma Corrector preset. We can say scale and hit OK. Now, anytime we want to apply this same effect, say we want to apply it to this clip that's a little bit farther down the timeline, I'm going to just come over here under my effects, and you should have a presets folder that is created in Premiere Pro for some reason. And if you know this, I can't figure it out, but my presets folder is like this crazy weird Russian letters. I have no idea. But if I open that up, you can see we have the Luma Corrector preset, and then I can click and drag this onto whatever clip I want. It's automatically going to save our keyframe values there, and we can just drag this effect on any clip within our timeline. And then I can open up the values and change them around accordingly. Another way I like to create my own transitions is by adding keyframe values on a nested sequence. What we're going to do is take the transition in between this clip of him on this basketball court and then transition into this clip of him in his car. So starting at this clip, what I'm gonna do is hold shift and I'm gonna go to the left once, and that's gonna take us 5 frames to the left. I'm gonna make a cut there on my first clip. I'm gonna hold shift, go to the right twice, so we're on that second clip now. And now we should have 10 frames with the split of both these clips being in the middle. So what I'm gonna do is highlight both these clips. I'm gonna right click and hit nest and hit okay. And I would say one of the most popular effects for transitions is just the zoom transition. So again, if we take a transform effect and throw it onto our nested sequence, we can actually do a custom zoom transition ourselves. So I'm gonna start our keyframe values there, and maybe we zoom in a little bit. Let's just zoom in a lot to like this middle part right here of the clip. And then towards the end of this transition, we're gonna zoom back out to where it is normally. So we start normal, we zoom in, and then boom, it zooms back out on the other side. So that's a pretty basic transition right there. But one thing I'm gonna do to make this look a little bit smoother is I'm going to turn up the shutter angle a bunch so we get this nice motion blur around the sides. And then what I'm going to do is highlight these first keyframes. I'm gonna right click them and hit easy ease out. And then I'm gonna highlight these last keyframes and I'm gonna click on easy ease in, because we're going into those values, right? So now we're gonna get this nice punch in zoom transition between these two clips just by applying some transform keyframes over a nested sequence. You can't tell me no, I can never go, I got my eyes on the road. Now, I understand that it could take time to develop all the effects and transitions that you want to in a timely manner. So that's why I've made my own preset pack available on VentureVisuals.com. And here under my effects tab, you can see that once you install these presets, they're all already keyframed and equipped to assist you in editing your videos a little bit faster. So I got some really clean transitions on here already keyframed. But with this nested sequence that we've created, what I can do is just take one of these transition presets here. Let's go with the vintage roll here and just click and drag that onto my nested sequence. And you can see we have all of these keyframe values already preset so that it gives you this transition right off the bat. You don't have to actually go in and create these transitions from scratch. If you're interested in downloading my personal transition preset pack called Blueprints, you can definitely check out the link down below. I've been using it a ton in my music video edits. It's been very, very useful for, you know, helping speed up the creative workflow and give me new ideas as I'm editing. So let's check out what this vintage roll transition preset from my blueprints pack looks like in full speed. Now the cool thing about when you download the transition presets off my website is anytime you apply them, you can actually open them up and turn off these effects one by one to see what each one is doing to create these transitions. It's a great way to not only discover what Premiere Pro is capable of when you combine different effects. And another great thing about this pack is that it's completely customizable. So say there's a transition preset that you throw onto your clips. Maybe you don't like that it's all noisy and grainy here. You can actually just turn off the noise and it's going to make an entirely new looking transition here. Say I don't like this transition as much, I can just delete all of these effects that go into the transition, and let's throw on a different one here. Let's throw on this one called Glitch Pop. Let's throw on the Glitch Pop transition. So we have kind of this glitchy transition happening. So if I render this out, let's check out what this transition looks like in full motion. You can tell me no, I can never go, I got my eyes on home. Let's try this one called Swipe Tilt here at the bottom. Let's drag that onto our clips. And this one is gonna look a little bit similar to our first one, our vintage roll, but we're going left to right now. And it's actually gonna look really, really sick. This is actually one of my favorite ones included in the pack. So let's render into out here. You can't tell me no, I can never go, I got my eyes on the road. This one's super clean. I love it. It's just subtle and it's, you know, I got a little style to it because it's kind of like called a swipe tilt because I designed it with this little tilt going on. You can see it. It's not perfectly up and down lines. So it just adds a little bit more to like the motion dynamic of the transition. So I thought this was a really cool one that's included in the pack. And again, you know, if I wanted to, I could open up any of these keyframe values and change anything about this transition really easily. You know, if I don't want to, all these keyframes are already ready and set to go, and they're guaranteed to speed up your workflow and make your creative edits hit a little bit harder. Keyframes are an essential part of any video edit, whether you're keyframing effects, transitions, motion graphics, or more. Keyframes are essential to understand for video editors. So I hope this tutorial helped some of you guys out there today understand the power of using keyframes. If you're interested in trying out my Blueprints transition pack, which you saw me demo briefly here in this video, you can check out my free pack on venturevisuals.com. The pack itself includes samples from all my packs on my website, including overlays, light leaks, transitions, and more. So if that sounds interesting to you, definitely check out my links in the description down below. If you're interested, send me a DM on Instagram. I'm happy to chop it up with you guys. And if you want to send me some of your work, that'd be sick too. I'm always curious to see what this community is up to and what you guys are creating. So I appreciate you guys tuning in again. Until next time, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.